I'm Steve Stine from GuitarZoom, and today what I'm going to be doing is breaking down the beginning of Free Ride by the Edgar Winter Group. This is just a really fun little thing to play, and it kind of gives you a nice introduction into 70s-style chord embellishments. It's pretty cool. So what we're going to do is we're going to build this whole thing up, but let's start with just the chordal shapes. So basically, if we go to the 7th fret and we press on the 2nd, 3rd, and 4th strings, and we make a bar there on the 2nd, 3rd, and 4th strings. And what we're going to do is we're going to add the middle finger onto the 8th fret of the 2nd string, and we're going to add the ring finger onto the 9th fret of the 4th string. This is kind of the quintessential 70s chord, is this whole... all that kind of stuff. And really, it's coming from a caged system. If you've ever studied the caged chording system, that's what they're using, okay? But basically, what we're going to do is we're going to take those sevens, we're going to convert it to adding the 8 and the 9 on, and then what we're going to do is we're going to take this entire thing and we're going to move up a whole step. So we're now barring over the 9s, and then we've got a 10 and 11, okay? So in this song, in Free Ride, we're actually going to start here and work our way backwards. So we're going to go, and then here. We're just moving back a whole step, and then we're going to take those fingers off again. So we have... okay. Sorry. It's kind of weird taking it out of context here, but... okay, so let's just practice that a little bit. Now, the strumming and everything, as we add in the other parts, it's going to change a little bit. But basically, what you're going to do is strum this twice, and then you're going to move down. And then you're going to strum with those two fingers off. So you have... then you're going to do the same sort of thing. You're going to go back to this 70s-style chord here on the 8 and the 9. And you're going to strum it once. And then you're going to take those fingers off. And then you're going to head down to an A power chord. So we have... and then... okay? So now what we're going to do is we're going to wrap around that with the little lick that happens. So what we're going to do here, we're going to slide up to the 9th fret. It doesn't matter where you slide from. It's called an airplane slide. That's what I call it anyway. So you're not going from 5 to 9 or 6 to 9. You're just kind of landing, right? The finger's just coming in somewhere. So you're not really hearing the first note. You're just hearing the slide effect. Okay? So as I play... see that? So I'm sliding into that 9 with my 3rd finger, and then I'm going to hit those 7s there. Now, if I had to be particular, I'm sliding somewhere around 5, but again, I'm not consciously paying attention to the starting note. I'm just moving into the slide. And then we're going to do it again. And then we're going to do... so we have... so it's a little bit... I mean, it's groovy, right? I mean, it's got a groove you got to kind of get comfortable with. Now, here's the trick. Is adding in this stuff. That's what really makes this riff come alive. So if you can do the chords that I just showed you, and you can do the little slide thing, and you can get used to that rhythm, that little pause, right? And then the second one is a different rhythm. You have bump, 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 right? You don't have to make them staccato. They don't have to be. You don't have to do that, but that's the rhythm. Now, the trick is if you can do all that, you start adding in this. Now, where you're really hearing it, right there. And I'm doing 4 of them. And then right there, I actually have 2 of them right there. There's two of them. See? Okay, now let me put that together so you can hear it as an actual musical entity, right? And then I have four more, which leads me back to the beginning again. Now, if you use less scratching or scratching in different places or whatever it might be, don't feel bad about that. It's a groove song. And, you know, that's always the hardest thing to talk about with people, sometimes anyway, is that music is something you got to feel. You know, we look at the tablature and we see the numbers and all that sort of thing. And not that we can't analyze it with notation, because we certainly can. But it actually kind of needs to start on this side. It needs to start on being able to feel it, you know, visualize it and feel it, and then, you know, use the notation to memorize it or whatever you might need to do. But, you know, if we break it down into its gut piece and just go, it's functional. It just doesn't sound very grooving, right? So then as we start adding in, that scratching, all of a sudden, it gives it more life. It gives it more of a percussive element. You know, not so much drums, but it's just giving you almost like a maraca, right? Or a shaker. Which gives you more of a real live feel when you play. So that's what I want you to think about, is try and build into being able to add that groove in there. It might take a little while, it might not, but don't stress over it. Just keep practicing it until it starts coming around for you. And again, if you do your scratching a little bit different than I'm doing it, or you're adding a little more, a little less, or in a different place or something like that, like I said before, do not feel bad about that. I don't wake up every day and like play songs by other artists and worry about whether or not everything that I'm doing is exactly perfect. I'm not concerned really about that at all. I'm more concerned with, now again, I have to play the chords right. I have to play the song structure correctly. But the little nuances that make a song sound human or make a song sound authentic, those kind of things have to come from me in my playing as best that I can do. So I'm not really worried about, you know, whether or not I'm doing it exactly the way you're doing it or the way they're doing it. It's when I present the song, when I play it, does it sound like the song? That's what I'm looking for. You know, because I grew up playing I started playing in the 80s, but, you know, the 70s and the 80s, that's the way everybody played back then, was, you know, you just listened to something and then you figured it out. So you were playing what you heard. You were playing what you felt. You weren't playing what was written down. You just played whatever it was. And you might get together with another person and they might play it a little differently than you. And again, most times, we've never really had to sit down and talk about what each other's doing, you know, another guitar player or something. We just play together. You know, they hear it that way. And as long as chordally and, you know, in terms of key and all that sort of thing, everything is jiving, as long as we're both feeling it, it sounds pretty cool. I've always thought of it more like the Rolling Stones kind of thing, where you have two players that, you know, are doing different things, but it's all working to serve the bigger purpose. So that's just something to think about. I'll stop yapping, but I want you to practice this. This is a really fun song. Explore it. Let us know on the Facebook community page how things are going. Post yourself playing this. You know, use the jam track. Post yourself playing it. Give us an update and let us know how things are going for you. And if you have any questions, contact us over at GuitarZoom, and we'd be more than happy to help you. So take care, practice hard, stay positive, and I will speak to you soon.